And then finally, avoid time-sensitive interpretations. Here's what I mean by that. Just for today, we're going to look at three beasts in Revelation. But as I studied this section this week, I saw all sorts of interpretations. Like, the dragon stands for artificial intelligence, which in the next 5 years is going to take over our world and planet. And they went through Revelation and saw how artificial intelligence and high-level computing is all over the book of Revelation. You can also see there's some ideas how the coronavirus is in the book of Revelation, because as we all know, corona stands for crown, and in the book of Revelation, crown is a very prevalent symbol that's used. So obviously, coronavirus is throughout the book of Revelation. Or one other thing I found is, if you look back at the events of 9/11 in the World Trade Center, the towers, there are actually books written claiming that, at least one author said, there were 40 predictions in the book of Revelation about what was going to happen on 9/11. These are just three examples, and I don't mean to make fun of this or belittle this. I love it that people are studying the Bible, but you should be aware of time-sensitive interpretations, because just picture this. Just picture this. God had John write out this book of Revelation in the late first century, which in itself is a task. But then just picture this. God is basically telling the first century Christians, hey, guys, I know you've got it rough, and I know you're doubting my existence and all, but could you take this book and could you make a bunch of copies? It means nothing for you, but the people 2,000 years from now are going to love it. What kind of a God would ask that of his people who are suffering and wondering where he is and saying, hey, here's something that people 2,000 years from now are really going to love? This is as applicable to the first century Christians as it is to people today. Avoid time-sensitive interpretations of what you see.